Starting this match right now, Brittany and Corey versus Jim and Mike. Corey in the black t-shirt is lagging against Jim, and it looks like Brittany and Corey are going to be the first to break. And it's a race to two from the one loss side. Once again, we do have additional action coming after this tournament, which is just going to be in a couple of matches after this. And who do we have left? Do we have a bracket? Do we have players left? What's going on?
No.
How many matches? No. Just no? You're not going to go look and help me out?
Oh, is that what you're asking?
Yes, please. That would be great. Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing good.
Mike,
just,
right?
Yeah. Okay. I just texted my wife, and yeah. It's P.O. It's
POVpool.com.
Okay. Yeah. I told her that way she could watch it.
All right. What's your wife's name?
Katrina Beaudry.
Katrina Beaudry. We got Mike Beaudry, your husband, playing with Jim. And they're going to play Race to Two against Brittany and Corey. Corey's breaking now. You got anything that you'd like to say?
I'm just saying thanks to my family and TAP for all the wonderfulness that we get to enjoy every year. Thank you.
Awesome, man. Mike Beaudry. When Mike speaks, people listen. All right, so dry break, and Jim is looking at the five ball. 8 ball, a game of strategy. You know, tell you what, I feel like that's a mistake because those two stripes down at the bottom end of the table are covering solid pocket, solid the 3 ball and the 2 ball. So I might have opted to play stripes, but we'll see what happens. Brittany, I don't know what the skill level spread is here between Brittany and Corey. Corey's playing the combo, and looks like the cue ball might have rolled a little too far to make that 15. A little close to the work. Not going to be an easy shot, so Brittany's looking at the 11 ball now. She's calling the 15 to the corner pocket. Jacking up the cue a little. Looks like a nice cue she's got there. Didn't go. So Jim's turn now. Good.
You have about 10 matches.
What?
More?
Yeah.
Get out of here. No.
Total.
Okay.
Not on the string table. No. 1, 2, 3.
I don't know how many tables you can use. And the way it's laid out on the track.
Interesting.
What?
What?
Mike Beaudry, by the way, if you missed it, Mike, this is a shout out to Mrs. Beaudry. He just gave you a shout out earlier. Seven did not go. I think she's trying to hit the 11-15 combo. Oh, just clipped the one on the way down. Chalk and some tiger shirts and Kamui t-shirts.
Tiger shirts. I got out of gloves.
What's that?
I got out of gloves.
Dude, this glove is amazing.
I can't use it.
I didn't think so either, but then when I tried this glove.
What, are you selling this stuff?
Yeah.
You don't have shirts.
POV shirts.
What do you mean? POV shirts? I'm going to get some soon. Yeah.
Well, keep one for me. Double XL.
I will. All right, man. Maybe next time I see you, I'll have some.
That'd be cool.
Yeah.
Get Steve Dittmer to do it.
Not a bad idea. I'll have to ask him.
Because he actually opened up a new shop.
I got a couple of other companies I'm working on pricing, but I'll talk to Steve, actually.
Yeah, Steve's got a good deals right now.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm glad
he's always looking
that.
For work. So.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
He's just not doing good stuff anymore.
I could even just promote him in the tool, you know. He could put a small logo somewhere. I want it to be PLV only.
Ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages.
Are you guys still on the winner side?
Yep. No,
wait,
we're
no,
on the
one
losing
loss.
Side,
yeah.
But we're still playing.
Still in it. I saw you won your last match. All right, so he's got to hit this four ball. Otherwise, it'll be ball in hand. Looks like he cut the angle in half, and it's good, and it's going in. And so is Whitey. Something to point out right now. With ball in hand, you probably want to take the ball on the rail. So now that 14 could be a problem a little later on for these two players. But we'll see. See if they can't handle it. So looks like unintentional safety now. So these guys are kicking again to try to hit the eight this time. Tough ball to hit this one. Looks like he's taking the narrow route. I think he can hit this. He's gonna hit it, but is he gonna hit a rail? No, he didn't even hit it. Now, Brittany, take the 14. It's on the rail, it's the hardest ball. With ball in hand, you're better off shooting the tough shot. Gonna do it. She's gonna take the 15. Those balls on the rail, folks, those balls are not your friends. Wide. And the eight ball for Jim and Mike. There's no gimme. This one is for Mrs. Beaudry. Just short, but you know what? Good cue ball, because Brittany has a very difficult combination now, 14 to the 11. Wow, he took the bank? Oh my gosh. Interesting way to play that. I thought for sure he'd just try to cut it in. And the 11 is a blocker. Now what are you gonna do? Scenario. He's gonna hit it soft. Oh my God. You know what?
That's kind of a strange shot.
Not making the 11 may have helped him.
I think he can punch the 8 through.
Oh, sorry.
That was popping.
It's okay.
So what do you think, Ian? We'll have 20 teams next year?
Well, this will go back up north the next time around.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, so we'll end up having some more. This was just a difficult thing with the distance and the bay and the heat and everything else.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
Well, I wish you the best of luck.
Thanks. I mean, everybody here pretty much got a cue. And
so. Yeah, that's right. You raffled off like 13 cues?
12 cues, a couple balls.
Man,
stickers.
It pays.
Oh, yeah, everybody got paid here today.
It pays.
Everybody got paid to play today. So everybody showed up today, did well.
Yes. Geraldine would like to say something on behalf of all the women out there.
No, just on behalf of Nice Rack.
Oh, good. Yes.
Maybe you can help me interpret this, Daniel.
Okay.
Because they couldn't really do that. But they have an 8 and 9 ball tournament on Friday. So you lag, and whoever wins the lag gets to pick which game you play. So the winner.
Okay, well, that makes sense to me. It basically means that if you win the lag, you get to choose between 9 or 8 ball.
But then on the flyer, it says 10 ball pop.
First game. Who won that game?
Okay, please continue.
But then on the flyer, it says 10 ball pot up to $40 per ball, went up to $400.
That also means that they have a 10 ball break pot that happens on the side.
Oh, on the side.
Yeah. Cool. That's cool. So there's a... It's kind of interesting tournament. It's a 10-ball, it's a 9-ball slash 8-ball tournament.
With the second chance 10.
And you lag before your match, and whoever wins the lag chooses the game. I like that.
So it's every
And then on the side, there's a 10-ball break pot. So if you break the, every ball made is $40 on the break?
Up to.
Okay. And then if you make the 10-ball, you probably win something special.
Sure.
Like a big pot.
Yeah. So... so it's every Friday.
Okay.
Sign-ups start at 7:30 p.m. and the tournament starts at 8 p.m. There is also $50 added to every tournament.
Oh, that's great. Cool.
Yeah.
Good reason to come and play at Nice Rack in El Cajon on Main Street.
Full bar. Food.
Yes, with food.
You have to be 21 and over to get in.
Yes, we saw that happen today.
And they do have happy hour. From open to 7 p.m. every day.
Okay, awesome. Open to 7?
Yeah.
What time they open?
11 or noon?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I know some bars that open at 6 a.m.
No, it's 11 or noon.
Yeah, okay.
So don't show up here at 6 a.m. because they won't be open.
Well, there's plenty of room in the parking lot. You can show up at 6 a.m., catch a couple hours sleep, and then come in.
And drink.
And do whatever, you
Happy
know.
Happy hour.
Yeah.
They have darts. They have beer pong.
Yes, they have.
They have ping pong tables.
They have beer pong. Okay. Yeah. I saw the ping pong table.
Yeah, beer pong as well.
Beer pong as
and
well. And the automated jukebox, I guess, or not automated, Touch Tunes jukebox.
And five diamond bar boxes, which you see.
Yeah, yeah. These bar boxes are actually in great shape, and the pockets are tight.
And there's plenty of space in between tables. So you know how sometimes you play in a bar box tournament and it's a little snug and you're sitting on top of the other table? There is actually room here. They space them out really well, I think.
Okay, good. Okay.
They have great furniture.
Yeah, they do, actually. Solid furniture, you know.
Have you ever sat at like one of those little bistro tables and there's four people sitting there and you're sitting at a tournament and then you order food and then by the time, you know, you get your food, like the whole bistro table is a little like too snug with stuff?
No, that's never happened to me ever in my life.
Well, they have bigger square tables where you actually fit comfortably with four people.
Okay. I appreciate your explanation of it all.
And purse hooks on the walls.
I saw the purse hooks. Those are awesome. Which can double as jacket hooks, I guess. Or
sure.
Q hooks, if you want, you know.
Case, yeah.
Yeah.
Hanger case there.
Yeah, I saw the purse hook. And actually, they do have a brand new wall, which they're still waiting for an inspection on. But as soon as I've been told that as soon as that wall has been inspected, that's the wall that you're looking at now with all the stools against it. As soon as that wall's passed inspection, they are going to mount up a few flat screen TVs, possibly another service rail, and more purse hooks.
And they're a Chargers bar.
And they are a Chargers bar. That's awesome. I like that. That's a good idea for, you know, I love stealing ideas for tournaments, you know. We have a tournament and we're like,
pick your game.
Pick your game.
I like that. Yeah, I agree.
Pick your game. I want to play eight ball. I'll do like eight ball, nine ball, or one pocket. No, one pocket's too long.
Yeah. Well, then you get the one pocket players who would come out here and...
And they'd say, oh, I want to play one pocket. Oh, thank you, thank you. And the service here is great, too. Isn't it? Thank you very much.
Do you have cream or sugar?
Wow, this looks like a strong espresso coffee. Wow, these guys are they're going all out on us here. We're getting carte blanche here at nice rack. Back to this match. It looks like Jim and Mike are poised to do some damage here. They are up one game in a race to two. Don't know if that one has really a legitimate pocket. I think you got to play this off the 13. So one off the 13 in this corner pocket. That's a pretty creative shot by Mike Beaudry. And it almost goes. Came within an inch of going in. Yeah, they're coming up with the Corey dual shots here. Thank you. The next shot. He's calling the nine in the corner.
Play safe.
Mike and Jim will advance. Congratulations to those guys, and good luck to Corey and Brittany in the TAP League in the future. Thanks for coming out. They won a Q in the raffle, and you know, good on ya. So let's start another match. We're gonna be right back, you guys. Thanks for watching today. And don't forget, unscheduled action after 6 p.m. between myself and Jeff Sorensen, nine ball races to 10 for 100. I'm gonna give him three games on the wire. Gulp.